One of the treatments that we're hearing a lot about and we're very excited about is Lutetium-177. So can you explain how that works and the response rates that we're hoping to see?
So this is an injected radioactive substance that swims around in the body, finds the cancer, and kills it. It's obviously a very attractive format because the healthy cells in the body have limited exposure to the radiation, and the cancer takes the brunt of the radiation. So it's well tolerated, and the phase 3 trials that have been done are now completed, and we are waiting to see if the placebo group and the treatment group, you know, separate in terms of survival. And if that is confirmed, perhaps that information will be out over the next year or so. Then the FDA usually takes 3 to 6 months to review it and approve it. So this type of treatment is likely to be on the market probably in the next 18 to 24 months. It's an injection given every 6 weeks. It is well tolerated. It can cause a dry mouth because sometimes the salivary glands have some of the same attraction to the treatment as the cancer does. And it can cause some low blood counts because radiation can do that. It's not a prominent problem, but I believe that it'll be another arrow in our quiver in the next couple of years for people with advanced disease. There's some question as to whether this can be brought earlier in to treat earlier disease in the future. It'll probably depend on how much if there's lingering effects from the radiation exposure. You know, squirting radiation into your body, you say, well, what would the results be 10 years later? And we certainly don't know the answer to that yet.
So one of the things that I've heard patients kind of talk about is bipolar androgen therapy, and I've heard Dr. Moyad mention it at our conferences. Can you explain what this is and how will we see this play out as a prostate cancer treatment?
So our theme today has been talking about research and how does research impact people with prostate cancer. I think that people are interested for two reasons. One is they wonder if someday I'll be in a position where I run out of options and what new things are coming. And then others are starting to run out of options and they need something, a salvation. And this idea of giving people testosterone is an idea that's been around for a while. And people have obviously thought it sounds so counterintuitive. Give testosterone to someone with hormone-resistant prostate cancer, won't that just be fuel on the fire? And the surprising thing is that if you take people with prostate cancer who have very advanced prostate cancers that have been on Lupron and Xtandi and Zytiga and had chemotherapy, maybe some immune treatments in the past, and their PSA is still rising and the disease is metastatic, a percentage of them appear to get a drop in PSA and sometimes shrinkage of the tumor by being exposed to testosterone. There have been some laboratory studies that suggested this might be the case, but it seemed like such an outlandish idea that people have really been very nervous about testing it. But at a few universities, under very carefully controlled circumstances, it appears that that certain individuals will respond. And we're talking about people with advanced resistant cancers that really don't have any other options. I don't think giving testosterone as a therapeutic maneuver is going to benefit people with hormone-sensitive disease. We do know that people with early-stage disease that are on intermittent therapy, take Lupron, stop Lupron, take Lupron, stop Lupron, can do that. It doesn't cause a regression of the cancer to re-expose with testosterone in someone with hormone-sensitive disease. But in hormone-resistant disease, the treatment is a single injection of relatively high dose testosterone given every 60 days. The testosterone stays in the individual's bloodstream for a week or two. And of course, prior, the testosterone levels were very low because they're on Lupron or whatever. And so they get a big burst of testosterone and then the testosterone dissipates. They stay on their Lupron and then that's repeated every 60 days. And perhaps 25% of men, 20-25% of men will have a decline in PSA who really otherwise didn't have much of any options. So it's unexpected. The patients do feel good when they have testosterone. They're enjoying their testosterone and sometimes it's beneficial. The patients have to be carefully monitored. If there were acceleration of disease, obviously it needs to be stopped. And if people are already having some pain from the cancer in the bones, for example, I don't think it's a very good idea to be giving any testosterone to those individuals. But bipolar androgen therapy, or BAT, is gaining more interest and is probably going to be utilized to some degree in very select cases.
Hi everyone, this is my new puppy. We haven't named him yet, but I'm sure you'll hear his name soon. We're super excited about him, and he's going to be around for our outros, if he lets me do them. So anyway, if you can visit our website, PCRI.org, that'd be great. We have a ton of information out there for you, and don't forget to subscribe, right? Subscribe to our YouTube videos. That's him saying yes. And we come out with new prostate cancer videos every week. Have a great time.